I believe we need a universal basic income in the United States. A universal basic income is a direct cash transfer. That is, we give people a set amount of money per month, no strings attached. People will be free to buy groceries, diapers, pay rent, save for an emergency, pay for medical care, or simply take their family to a movie. One, work doesn't pay. People often work one, two, or three jobs and still live in poverty. In fact, work pays so little that a majority of Americans don't have $1,000 in the bank for an emergency. 95 million Americans live in poverty, and one in three parents can't afford diapers for their children. Two, we have a coming wave of automation that will displace millions of workers. We have to work on narrative change that we need. Now, universal basic income isn't a new idea. Milton Friedman and Richard Nixon believed in a version of universal basic income. Today, many people on the right and left support versions of this. I believe we can lift millions of people out of poverty with the universal basic income and give people the independence they deserve with a monthly cash disbursement. Giving people cash will create an economic stimulus. When you give people money, they spend the money, which helps boost small business and government revenues. Recent Nobel Prize winning work suggests that the best way to reduce poverty and help people is to actually give them agency, and this means giving people money. But then why are we so reticent to give people money? Well, because in the United States, we wrongfully believe that if we help struggling people and communities, that they'll never help themselves. Instead, we give big corporations and billionaires free money because we believe their wealth creates deservedness, so we keep giving more. This is uniquely American, and we have to come to terms with this fact and change our ways. That we blame poor people for poverty, and this is wrong. Our history is littered with examples. From President Reagan inventing the welfare queen, to drug testing and work requirements for public aid recipients, to communities preventing affordable housing from being built in their communities. So how do we change this narrative? First, we have to recognize that work doesn't pay. No matter how long and how much people work, they're not getting by, and they're certainly not getting ahead. Second, the confluence of student loans, housing instability, and childcare costs is driving inequality from the upper middle class all the way down. Many Americans, even those with six-figure incomes, are living check to check. And third, gains in productivity aren't being realized by average Americans. They're being hoarded by a few people at the top. Automation and artificial intelligence will only accelerate this trend. But there is good news. We can afford universal basic income. How? Well, for perspective, the federal government just passed a $1.2 trillion tax cut. About 35% of that, $400 billion, benefited foreign investors. A chunk of that $400 billion benefited foreign sovereign wealth funds. What do? Well, they invest in universal basic income, universal child care and infrastructure, and jobs in their own countries. We are literally financing social good abroad, but here at home, we let our prejudice cloud our ability to help our neighbors. Let's change the narrative. Let's give everyone a universal basic income and lift millions of people out of poverty and help our neighbors, and let's all get ahead.